In this video, we'll take a look at the non-normal procedure for when an engine has high vibration. The vibration gauges are electronically displayed on the upper display unit or at the bottom of the lower display unit depending on preference, and form part of the normal scan by both pilots. Vibration is measured by the airborne vibration monitoring system, which consists of two sensor accelerometers per engine, located at both the number 1 bearing and rear frame section of the engine. Here we can see the number 1 engine vibration gauge value increasing. It hasn't reached 4.0 to be considered high, but it is of note. Also of note is the increased fuel flow of the number 1 engine in comparison to the number 2 engine. It could indicate a potential issue given that the engine has increasing vibration and also increased fuel flow. Let's watch the indications of high vibration when 4 units is exceeded. The instrumentation from the lower display unit is moved to the upper display in view of the pilots, and a white box flashes for 10 seconds before being steady. Notice the number 1 engine vibration value text has reversed color, with black text now shown on a white box. Recognizing an issue exists, the pilot flying states,
"My aircraft."
This ensures someone is flying the aircraft, while the other pilot can focus on the issue. The pilot flying then calls for the high vibration checklist. The pilot monitoring first checks the quick reference card if applicable, then proceeds to the quick reference handbook, known as QRH, to look for a non-normal procedure for engine vibration. Depending on the variant of QRH, the procedure is listed as either high engine vibration or engine high vibration. In neither variant of the QRH was the procedure listed under V for vibration. As covered in many of our videos, the first step is for the pilots to agree if this is the correct checklist for the condition. The pilot monitoring reads the title, condition, then asks if the pilot flying agrees it is the correct checklist. This sounds like
high engine vibration checklist. Condition, both of these occur, the vibration level is more than 4 units, and airframe vibrations. Do you agree?
I agree.
The first step is conditional and depends if an icing conditions or not. As we are not in icing conditions, we choose the second path, which directs us to step 4. Had we been in icing conditions, the checklist would have had us momentarily increase thrust. Step 4 has us disengage the auto throttle if it's engaged. Step 5 states to retard thrust on the affected engine to maintain vibration levels below 4 units. However, the note underneath says that if the vibration indication does not decrease when the thrust lever is retarded, to check other engine indications. If those are normal, no further action is needed. As we retard thrust on the number 1 engine, while the fuel flow decreases, the vibration is staying the same. With the other engine indications being normal, no further action is needed. Returning to the checklist, the 4 black boxes indicate the checklist has been completed. The pilot monitoring then states to the pilot flying,
"High engine vibration checklist complete."
In this video, we took a look at the indications for high engine vibration, followed by running the applicable non-normal procedure from the quick reference handbook. We also saw that despite having high vibration, the engine continued to generate thrust and is not shut off. We hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe to learn of our future videos. Thank you.